الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على خاتم النبيين، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Please recite after me. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. نويت سنة الاعتكاف. أو بنور آقا مكي مدني مصطفى صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وسلم has said very beautifully. The person who recites 200 times the durood on the day of Jumu'ah, Allah Azza wa Jal will forgive his 200 years sins. Sallu ala al-Habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, salatu wa salam alayka ya Sayyidi ya Rasulullah, wa ala alika wa ashabika ya Habib Allah. Our beloved Aqa, the last prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has said very beautifully, أَفْضَلُ الْعَمَلِ أَنِّيَّةُ الصَّادِقَةُ. A truthful intention is the best action. A truthful intention is the best action. So let us try to make some good intentions. We are here in the weekly Ijtima of Dawat Islami, and as well as today is Urse Ala Hazrat. The 25th night of Safarul Muzaffar is Urse Ala Hazrat. Who is Ala Hazrat? We will try to, inshallah, Azza wa Jal, listen in this bayan today, inshallah. So what is the good intentions we can make? I will listen to the entire speech to gain knowledge of Islam, inshallah, Azza wa Jal. Number two, I will sit in respectful manner as much as possible. Number two, I will not be lazy or attentive during the speech. I will listen to the speech to reform and better myself, inshallah azza wa jal. Whatever I will hear, I will try to convey to others as well, inshallah azza wa jal. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. A very, very beautiful hadith of Barakah. Ala Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala Alayhi have wrote in Fatawa-e Razviya Sharif. Today we are celebrating the Urs of Ala Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala Alayhi. So inshallah Azza wa Jal, through the teachings of Ala Hazrat. Who is Ala Hazrat? His name is Hazrat Imam Ahmad Raza Khan Rahmatullah Ta'ala Alayhi. We known as he born in India, in Bareilly Sharif. Now his Mazar Mubarak, his grave is also in India. He was the very, very, very pious and the mujaddid of the deen in the last century of his. I'm trying to summarize in the short words who is Ala Hazrat. But inshallah azza wa jal, brothers our from Soweto, especially we wanted to know who is Ala Hazrat. Your Alim Deen, mashallah, your Imam Sahib is here. He is giving so many lectures as well as in your own masjid. So ask him, who is Ala Hazrat? After the bayan, tomorrow, maybe inshallah, Azza wa Jal, in your speech, in the bayan, in the lecture, on the Friday, he will deliver more about Ala Hazrat. Who is Ala Hazrat? We have to know about Ala Hazrat. Why? Because we are sitting here as the Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah, it is a sadqa, it is a wasila of Ala Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala Ali. Why we should not celebrate the Urs of Ala Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala Ali? We are Sunni Alhamdulillah through Ala Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala Ali. So what Ala Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala Ali wrote in Fatawa-e Razviya Sharif? He says, one day a Jibreel came into the court of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Jibreel alayhi salam, Aqa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ki barakah mein hazir huye. What Jibreel says? Listen very carefully this hadith mubarakah, very, very carefully. What Jibreel says? Jibreel says, As-salamu alayka ya zahiru, As-salamu alayka ya batinu. O Zahir Prophet, may salam be upon you. O Batin Prophet, may salam be upon you. The greatest prophet, Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam declared, Jibreel, these attributes are for Allah and they befit only Him. How could they be utilized in my regard? Now Aqa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam is asking to Jibreel to just clarify to their ummati. Aqa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam knows each and everything. Who is he? But he knows the ummati of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. They will recite, they will read this Hadith Mubarakah one day to know his status. Jibreel replied, Allah Almighty has granted you excellence by these attributes. Who granted you? Allah. You were granted a rank above all other prophets and messengers. From his names and attributes, he bestowed upon you names and qualities. Subhanallah. He named you Awwal. It means the first. He names you Awwal, the first one, as you were made before all other prophets. Other, he named you Akhir, as you came after the eras of other prophets, and you are the final prophet of the final Ummah. Look at the beautiful words Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to Jibreel alayhi salam. Allah Almighty named you as Batin. Listen very carefully. Now what Jibreel is saying, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you as Sid, as you Batin? 2000 years before Adam alayhi salam was created, he wrote your name in light next to his all the pillars of Arsh. This shall remain there forever. How many years before? Who is listening intentively? Who is listening carefully? How many years before? 2000 years before the creator, like before the creation, before create Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, 2000 years before he wrote his name with his name and Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam on the pillars of Arsh Mubarak. Subhanallah. He then ordered me to recite salat upon you. I spent this sentence gave me a very pleased, like I was so much happy. What beautiful recitation or the salawat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not something ordinary. What? He says, I spent 1000 years doing this and another 1000 reciting salam. Who was reciting? Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salam. This continued until Allah Almighty sent you as a giver of glad tidings, a warner, a call to Him, and an illuminating light. Subhanallah. Allah Almighty, I also titled you Zahir, as He granted you prominence over every religion. Your system of law and virtue has been made apparent to all in both. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Almighty has sent salat, mercy upon you. Your Lord is Mahmud, the praised one. And you are Muhammad, he who is praised. Your Lord is Awwal, Akhir, Zahir and Batin. And you, by the bestowal of your Lord, are Awwal, Akhir, Zahir and Batin. Subhanallah. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Who wrote this? Imam Ahmad Raza Khan rahmatullahi ta'ala in Fatawa Azwiya. He said to us, who was Imam Ahmad Raza Khan rahmatullahi ta'ala? He was not an ordinary person. Look at the blessings upon Ala Hazrat rahmatullahi ta'ala. Let me tell you one incident to our brothers. One incident is that Allah Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala Alayhi was very young. At the time of around four years. And look at the karamat of Allah Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala Alayhi as well. At the time of 4 years, He already knows how to read Quran Pak full Nazira. At the time of 4 years, our children today, even if 6 years, even if 7 years, we are still sending him into madrasa to learn the Quran, just that Madani Qaida. For starting, for 5 years, how old is the child? Allah Hazrat already knows how to read Quran Nazira. So what happened one day? Qari Sahib, his ustad, and his age is around 4 years, and his ustad is teaching him the Quran. Now the key teacher, also a great teacher, not any ordinary teacher, but he memorized the Quran. But one day what happened? By mistake, as a human, teacher was teaching him something from the Quran Pak, one ayah. The teacher was reading Zabar on one word. Now Allah Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala, at the time of 4 years age, he is trying to reading that ayat mubarakah with zabar, but automatically with his tongue, the zair is coming out from his tongue. It's continuously happening, continuously happening. His grandfather was sitting next to him. He knew it. The child is very intelligent. He normally does not do these kind of mistakes. So Dada Jan, grandfather, he ordered, bring another Quran Pak. Bring another book of Quran, the Quran Pak, another jild. So what he says, he saw the mistake was from the person who wrote the Quran Pak. There was not Zabar, it's supposed to be Zair, which Allah Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala was reading. It was 100% accurate. The teacher who was reading, it was slightly, there was a mistake. And he was also not making a mistake because he was reading from Quran Pak. But Allah Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala, I wanted to tell you who he is. He is a by born, ulama says, he is the wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected him from all kind of mistakes. So this one incident proves us that Allah Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala is by born wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Time is very short, very limited. Inshallah Azza wa Jal, let me try to give some bayan lecture in Urdu as well. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala khatami nabiyyin. Piyari Abbas sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam ki shan ke kya kehne? Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salam ka jo waqia humne suna ke hadith mubarakah mein likha gaya. Piyari Abbas sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam ek martaba farishton ke sardar, aur ye kahan bhi likha hai, Fatawa Razviya mein likha hai, Ala Hazrat ne likha, Allah Hazrat ka urs mana rahe hain, Allah Hazrat ne Fatawa Razviya mein jild number 15 safa number 663 par ye khatm e nabuwat par daleel di ke ala pyare aqa sallallahu taala alaihi wa sallam aakhri nabi hain. Aw bilawad aqa sallallahu taala sallam is the last prophet of Allah subhanahu wa taala. Ek martaba farishton ke sardar Hazrat Jibril alaihi salam aapki bargah mein hazir hue aur yu salam kiya, assalamu alayka یا ظاہر ہو, السلام علیکہ یا باطن ہو, اے ظاہر نبی آپ پر سلام ہو, اے باطن نبی آپ پر سلام ہو. اس پر پیارے آپ کا مکی مدنی مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے فرمایا, اے جبریل یہ صفات تو اللہ پاک کی ہیں, اسی کو لائق ہیں, میرے لیے یہ صفات کیسے ہو سکتی ہیں؟ حضرت جبرائیل علیہ السلام نے عرض کیا, اللہ پاک نے آپ کو ان صفات سے فضیلت دی, آپ کو سارے نبیوں اور رسولوں پر فضیلت بخشی, اور اپنے نام اور صفت سے آپ کا نام اور وصف نکالا ہے. اے پیارے محبوب صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, اللہ پاک نے آپ کا نام اول رکھا کیونکہ آپ پیدائش کے اعتبار سے بائی برت, اللہ پاک نے آپ کا نام اول رکھا کیونکہ آپ پیدائش کے اعتبار سے بائی برت سب انبیاء کرام سے پہلے ہیں, کہ سب سے پہلے آپ کا نور مبارک پیدا کیا گیا. اللہ پاک نے آپ کا نام پاک آخر بھی رکھا کیونکہ آپ سب انبیاء کرام کے زمانے سے آخر میں تشریف لانے والے اور آخری امت کے آخری نبی ہیں. اسی طرح اللہ پاک نے آپ کا نام باطل بھی رکھا، کیونکہ اللہ پاک نے اپنے نام کے ساتھ آپ کا نام پاک نور کے ساتھ عرش کے پائے پر حضرت آدم علیہ السلام کی پیدائش سے 2000 سال پہلے ہمیشہ ہمیشہ کے لیے لکھا، پھر مجھے آپ پر درود شریف پڑھنے کا حکم دیا تو میں نے آپ پر 1000 سال درود اور 1000 سال سلام بھیجا، یہاں تک کہ اللہ پاک نے آپ کو خوشخبری دیتا اور ڈر سناتا، اللہ پاک کے حکم کی طرف بلاتا اور چمکا دینے والا سورج بنا کر بھیجا، سبحان اللہ۔ اسی طرح اللہ پاک نے آپ کا نام پاک ظاہر بھی رکھا، کیونکہ اس نے آپ کو تمام دینوں پر غلبہ عطا فرمایا، آپ کی شریعت و فضیلت کو تمام زمین و آسمان والوں پر ظاہر کیا، تو کوئی ایسا نہ رہا جس نے آپ پر درود نہ بھیجا ہو، اللہ پاک آپ پر درود یعنی رحمت بھیجے، پس آپ کا رب محمود یعنی تعریف کیا گیا ہے اور آپ محمد یعنی تعریف کیے گئے ہیں، آپ کا رب اول و آخر ظاہر و باطن ہے اور آپ بھی اپنی رب کی عطا سے اول و آخر ظاہر و باطن ہے، سبحان اللہ۔ صلو علی الحبیب، ہم آخری نبی کی آخری امتی ہیں، اے عاشقان رسول اللہ پاک کا ہم گناہگاروں پر اتنا بڑا فضل و کرم اور احسان ہوا کہ اللہ عز و جل نے ہمیں اپنے پیارے نبی آخری نبی صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم کی امت میں پیدا فرمایا، اس امت میں آنے کے لیے انبیاء کرام دعائیں کیا کرتے تھے، اسی لیے ہم سب کو معلوم ہے کہ چوتھے آسمانوں پر حضرت عیسیٰ علیہ السلام ابھی بھی زندہ موجود ہیں، حضرت عیسیٰ علیہ السلام قیامت سے کچھ قبل پہلے اس دنیا میں تشریف لائیں گے، انسان کی حیثیت سے تشریف لائیں گے اور نبی بن کر نہیں آئیں گے بلکہ پیارے آقا صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم کے امتی بن کر آئیں گے اور اسی دین کی دین اسلام کی آپ ترویج و اشاعت کریں گے۔ میرے پیارے پیارے اسلامی بھائیو، اللہ پاک نے ہمیں پیارے آقا صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم کا جو امتی بنایا، کوئی پیارے آقا صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم کے جیسا نہ کوئی اس دنیا میں پہلے تھا، نہ کوئی پیارے آقا صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم کے جیسا قیامت تک آ سکتا ہے۔ ہم یہ نہیں کہتے کوئی آ ہی نہیں، آئے گا ہی نہیں، ہم یہ کہتے نہ کوئی آ سکتا ہے بلکہ نہ کوئی پہلے تھا نہ کوئی قیامت تک آئے گا۔ میرے پیارے پیارے اسلامی بھائیو، ایک شخص نے اعلی حضرت رحمت اللہ تعالی علیہ سے سوال کیا، one day a person came in the court of اعلی حضرت رحمت اللہ تعالی علیہ، he asked a question، او اعلی حضرت رحمت اللہ تعالی علیہ please tell me what was the question، is there is anyone who can be like محمد in this world before and after، what was the question، is there is anyone، کوئی ایسا بھی ہو سکتا ہے کہ محمد جیسا پہلے یا بعد میں پیدا کر دیا جائے؟ اعلی حضرت رحمت اللہ تعالی علیہ نے کیا پیارا جواب ارشاد فرمایا، حالانکہ سائل کا question یہ نہیں تھا کہ کوئی نبی آ سکتا ہے، صرف یہ پوچھا کہ کیا کوئی محمد بھی آ سکتا ہے؟ اعلی حضرت رحمت اللہ تعالی نے بہت پیارا جواب ارشاد فرمایا، فرمایا he says محمد صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وآلہ وسلم he is the رسول of اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی، he is اول as we said before، what is the means of اول، the first one، وہی is the آخر، who is the last one، he is ظاہر، he is the باطن، نبیوں کے سردار بھی ہیں، مالک و مختار بھی ہیں، اللہ پاک نے انہیں رحمت للعالمین بنا کر بھیجا اور خاتم النبیین کا تاج بھی انہیں عطا فرمایا، he is the خاتم النبیین who is the last prophet of اللہ سبحانہ وتعالی، he says further he says there is no one like محمد before محمد and there is no one like محمد can be until the day of judgment، اعلی حضرت رحمت اللہ تعالی علیہ why he says that، further he says if there is anyone like محمد after Muhammad what you going to give him the title، he can be any other nabi، he can be like a nabi، oh he is bringing any other nabuwa or the sharia، Allah Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala says when there is no possibility there is no other nabi
after Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So this is the reason now there is no Muhammad can be after Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. My dear Islamic brothers, that's why in Urdu they say, tera misl nahi hai khuda ki qasam, koi tujh sa hua hai na hoga shaha, mujhe khali ke husn o ada ki qasam. Allah Hazrat rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says very beautifully in his poetry, hai kalame ilahi mein shamsu duha, tere chehra e noore faza ki qasam, qasam e shab e tar mein raaz ye tha ke habib ki zulf e dota ki qasam, tere khilq ko haq ne azim kaha, tere khulq ko haq ne jameel kiya, koi tujh sa hua hai na hoga shaha, tere khaliq ko husn o ada ki qasam. There is no one like Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. There cannot be anyone until the day of judgment. No one can be like Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Ala Hazrat rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, he's giving us the aqeedah of Ahle Sunnah wal Jama'ah. That what is the aqeedah? That last Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. He is not giving this aqeedah from his own intellect. He is not giving this aqeedah from any ordinary book. He is giving us the aqeedah from the Quran Pak. What Quran says, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَحَدٍ مِّن رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَاكِ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ علیمہ. قرآن says تمہارے مردوں میں کسی کے باپ نہیں ہے لیکن اللہ کے رسول ہیں اور سب نبیوں کے آخر میں تشریف لانے والے ہیں اور اللہ سب کچھ جاننے والا ہے. یہ قرآن ہمیں عقیدہ دے رہا ہے کہ اللہ کے آخری نبی کون ہے؟ محمد صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم. ہمارا اپنا عقیدہ کہاں سے آیا؟ اللہ نے ہمیں قرآن میں بتایا یہ عقیدہ. اعلی حضرت رحمت اللہ تعالی نے اس آیت کی تفسیر بھی کچھ یوں بیان فرماتے ہیں. کئی علماء کرام نے, شروع سے صحابہ کرام نے, تابعین نے, تبع تابعین نے, جید علماء کرام نے اس آیت مبارکہ کی تفسیر بیان کی. اعلی حضرت بھی اس کی تفسیر بیان کرتے ہیں. اعلی حضرت کیا فرماتے ہیں کہ خاتم النبیین کا معنی ہے آخری الانبیاء, یعنی سب سے آخری نبی. What is the meaning of خاتم النبیین? That the meaning of Khatam al-Nabiyyin, the last prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Huzur sallallahu ta'ala wa sallam ke saath, ya aap sallallahu ta'ala wa sallam ke baad, qiyamat tak kisi ko nubuwat milna muhaal hai. Look at the aqeedah of Allah Hazrat rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, how beautifully he is trying to teaching us the aqeedah of Ahle Sunnah. He says, ayat ke is maayni mein kisi kisam ki ta'wil ya takhsis karna, apni marzi ke maayni nikalna, kufr. Whoever don't believe that there can be any possibility that Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala, after Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, can be any other prophet, he is non-Muslim same time. He cannot be Muslim at all. Further he says, why I'm saying in English, please mark, we cannot continue in Urdu all the bayan, but for the brothers, because this is a very, very important point in our life. The person cannot be a Muslim if he thinking that there can be any Nabi after Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Further he says, Allah Hazrat rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, like he give this example, like there is no Allah, cannot be any other Allah, same like that there cannot be any prophet after Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. He says it's final, full and final. There is no doubt about it. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. حدیث پاک کی مشہور کتاب مسلم شریف میں اللہ پاک کے آخری نبی محمد عربی صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم نے فرمایا, اللہ پاک نے زمین و آسمان کی پیدائش سے, زمین و آسمان کی پیدائش سے 50,000 سال پہلے مخلوق کی تقدیر لکھی. اس وقت لوح محفوظ پر جو کچھ لکھا گیا اس میں یہ بھی تھا, انا انا محمدا خاتم النبیین, بے شک محمد صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وآلہ وسلم سب سے آخری نبی ہے. مسلم شریف کی حدیث مبارکہ ہے. میرے پیارے پیارے اسلام بھائیو، اللہ عز و جل کی رحمت ہے کہ ہم اللہ عز و جل کی رحمت سے اس کے پیارے حبیب صلی اللہ تعالیٰ علیہ وآلہ وسلم کے امتی ہیں. We are the blessed one. Why? We are the ummah of Rasulullah صلی اللہ تعالیٰ علیہ وآلہ وسلم. There is no other prophet after Muhammad صلی اللہ تعالیٰ علیہ وآلہ وسلم and there cannot be any prophet after Muhammad صلی اللہ تعالیٰ علیہ وآلہ وسلم. From today's عرص of Allah حضرت رحمت اللہ تعالیٰ علیہ by the teaching of Allah حضرت رحمت اللہ تعالیٰ علیہ, we are trying to teaching our brothers, we are trying to learning ourselves. This is the aqeedah of awliya-i karam. This is the aqeedah of our pious buzurgani deen. This is the aqeedah of every mu'min. This is the aqeedah of every believer. This is the aqeedah of every sahabi. This is the aqeedah of every tabi'i. This is the aqeedah of every muslim. There cannot be any Nabi after Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. He is the last prophet of Rasulullah. He is the last prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear Islam brothers, that is why our Amir Ahl Sunnah also have given us very beautiful couplets. Muhammad Mustafa, let us recite together. Let us read together loudly. I will say Muhammad Mustafa, everybody have to say Sab Se Akhri Nabi. Sab Se Akhri Nabi means in Urdu, the last prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let us raise our hands and today we have to be witness. There is no one after Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam like him. Say loudly, Muhammad Mustafa, Muhammad Mustafa, Amina ka ladla, عقیدہ سب صحابہ کا, عقیدہ سارے اولیاء کا, عقیدہ ہم سب کا, عقیدہ ہے عطار کا. سب سے آخری نبی, سب سے آخری نبی, سب سے آخری نبی. This is the عقیدہ of our, this is fundamentals of Islam, that believe, we should have firm belief in our heart. There cannot be any prophet after Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Give this belief to every child in our community, in Muslims. There cannot be any Nabi after Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And to add some more things on it, there is many people, they are in this world, they are trying to catching our iman. They are trying to giving us the mis. They are trying to misleading us from the right path, which is a right path that Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam is Akhri Nabi. And some of the people, they talk against our Sahabi, the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is called Sahabi. So this is also our belief. Every Sahabi, every companion of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam is Jannati. Cannot go in Jahannam. He is Jannati. They are Jannati. That is why Amir Ahl Sunnat says very beautifully, Har Sahabi ye Nabi,
Jannati.
Har Sahabi ye Nabi, Jannati, Jannati. Sab Sahabiyat bhi, Jannati, Jannati. So we have to be firm on our beliefs, on our aqidah. Inshallah, Azza wa Jal, sallu ala al-habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, salatu wa salamun alayka sayyidi Rasulullah. Let us try to recite our weekly durud-e-pak. Saints of Islam have quoted that whoever recites this durud at least once on the night preceding Friday on the regular basis, he will be blessed with the vision of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam at the time of death, as well as at the time of his burial into the grave, to the extent that he will see the noble Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam lowering him into the grave with his own blessful hands. Let us recite together. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammadin النبي الأمي الحبيب العالي القدر العظيم الجاه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. It is narrated by Sayyidina Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu that the beloved Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has stated, whoever recites this durood upon me while standing, then prior to his sitting back, and if he recites it while sitting, then before he stands back, his sins will be forgiven. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وسلم. Whoever recites the rule, 70 portals of mercies are open for him. Allah sallallahu ala Muhammad. Sheikh Ahmad Sahabi rahmatullahi ta'ala reports from some scenes of Islam that the one reciting this darood once received the reward of reciting the rule 600,000 times. Let us recite together. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin adada ma fi ilmillahi salatan da'imatan bidawami mulkillah. One day somebody came into the court of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. The noble prophet Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam made him sit between himself and Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The companions, they were surprised who that honored person was. When he had left, the noble prophet Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, when he recites the rule upon me, he does so in these words. اللهم صل على محمد كما تحب وترضى له. The greatest Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has stated, the one who recites his darood upon me, my intercessions will become wajib for him. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa anzilhu al-maq'ada al-muqarraba indaka يوم القيامة. It is narrated by Sayyidina Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma that the noble prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has stated, for the reciter of above supplications, 70 angels write good deeds in his account for 1,000 days. Jazallahu anna Muhammadan ma huwa ahlu. The holy prophet Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, if anyone recites the following dua 3 times at night, it is if he has found Laylatul Qadr. Let us recite together. La ilaha illallah, Al-Halimul Kareem, Subhanallah, Rabbis Samawati, As-Sab'i, Wa Rabbil Arshil Azim. La ilaha illallah, Al-Halimul Kareem, Subhanallah, Rabbis Samawati, As-Sab'i, Wa Rabbil Arshil Azim. لا إله إلا الله الحليم الكريم سبحان الله رب السماوات السبع ورب العرش العظيم صلوا على الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم.